Hello and welcome to Signature TV News Highlights for this Friday. I am Damilola Abudu. Tanzania's Samia Suluhu Hassan was on Friday sworn in as the country's first female president after the sudden death of John Magufuli, a 61 years old Hassan, a soft-spoken Muslim woman from the island of Zanzibar who finished Magufuli's second five-year tenure, set to run until 2025. Wearing a bright red headscarf, Hassan was sworn in as the country's sixth president at a ceremony in Dar es Salaam, where neither she nor the majority of the attendees wore a mask in the COVID-sceptic nation. Though River State Governor Esam Wike has said that banditry may not end in the country because of the whole progressive-led government has continued to politicize security. Governor Wike, in a statement by his special assistant on media, Kelvin Ebiri, said by politicizing insecurity, the APC government plunged the security-troubled state into an unimaginable banditry scale that may not end soon. He explained that when Rivers experienced insecurity in 2015, he ran to the federal government, but instead of getting their support, they dismissed it because they wanted to make the state remain ungovernable. The senator representing Imo West Senatorial District, which has a coverage on Thursday, congratulated Senator Ifeanyi Ararume at the Federal High Court Abuja on his victory as the authentic candidate of the All Progressives Congress in the Imo North Senatorial by-election held on December 5th, 2020. Okoroicha's congratulatory message was contained in a statement signed on his behalf by his media advisor Sam Onwemundo, which was made available to newsmen in Uwere, Imo State. Earlier, Justice Taiwo of the Federal High Court Abuja declared Senator Ifeanyi Ararume as the winner of the by-election on the grounds that Ararume was the duly nominated candidate of the APC for the election, and also ordered the Independent National Electoral Commission to issue Ararume a certificate of return within 72 hours from the date of the delivery of the judgment to facilitate his inauguration as senator by the president of the Senate. The Igbo Apex Sociocultural Organization, or ANEZE in the Igbo, has described the People's Democratic Party's report on the 2022 presidential election, which throws its ticket open, as most wicked, unreflective and unacceptable. The Bala Mohammed-led PDP Committee on the Review of the 2019 General Elections had recommended in a report submitted to the National Chairman of the party, Chief Uche Secondus, that the party should allow all aspirants from all parts of the country to contest its 2023 presidential ticket. Mohammed was quoted to have remarked that, in line with certain unwritten conventions of the nation's history, many people think that for fairness and equity, the North, East and Southeast geopolitical zones that have had the shortest stint at the presidency should be given special consideration in choosing the presidential flag bearer of the party for the 2023 election. Wanese said that, for the avoidance of doubt, Nigerians agreed on the rotation of the presidency between the North and the South, in which case it is a turn of the South, after the tenure of President Muhammadu Buhari. Paul Pogba's close-range goal has sent Manchester United to the quarter-final of the Europa League, handing Ole Gunnar's side a 1-2 aggregate win over AC Milan. United won the second leg of the game 0-1 on Thursday, after the English were last week forced to a 1-1 draw in the reverse fixture. The French star was introduced to the game in the 46th minute, and it took a few minutes for the former Juventus man to make an instant impact on his return from injury. Please do also stay safe, maintain physical and social distance, and wear your nose mask while going about your daily activities. That's the Signature TV News highlight. For details, visit www.signaturetv.org. And don't forget to join us later in the evening for Signature 30 Minutes. On behalf of my producer, Anita Eze, thanks for watching. I am Damilola Abudu.